So good morning all, and thank you for being here for this webinar. I am Richie. I am an application engineer at Adomex Technologies, and today we will see how SolidWorks can be used along with 3D Experience Platform, which is very new to the industry. But with the use of 3D Experience Platform, how we can create part modeling, the parts, assemblies. Then we also have sheet metal and organic modeling, all built in the browser-based solution. So let's begin. So for the contents, as you know that we are struggling or fighting through the situation, and due to the situation, probably the outcome is limited. Or we want a solution wherein we can tackle and get the maximum benefits while being at home, or probably while having a limited resource at our office. Then we will introduce you to 3D Experience Platform. Then we have some roles. So the role means each designer or each individual will get a specific role as per his job KRA, and then each role has some specific apps. So with that role, you get some apps. So the apps are situated in your login credential. You simply have to use your browser and open the app and do your work. So no local installation is necessary for this. Some apps might require some local installation wherein it synchronizes the data to your local drive and so on. Again, we'll see how we can integrate all the content which we create from the platform to our existing SolidWorks. So you'll see the integration module also. And we have some fun stuff, like we can create the complete parametric modeling or complete organic modeling in the browser, irrespective if you have SolidWorks or if you don't have SolidWorks or if you have any other platform. So these are about the contents. Okay, so in this situation, you know that we are having this situation and facing issue with the collaboration of teams. So now you might be a part of some team. So you might be a part of design team. You might be a part of manufacturing team. But as due to COVID, probably you might have a limited resource, like not all people might be visiting to office or working from office. Some might be there might be a schedule wherein half of the staff might go on Tuesdays, half of the team might go on Thursdays and so on. So there's a collaboration issue wherein the team is scattered across different locations and they cannot speak together or they cannot work together. Then accessing the data, like sometimes as a designer, you want to access the legacy data or probably the older data, which is available in your office premises, or you might have forgotten to copy the data to your laptop, which is provided to work from home. So in that situation, the access of the data is very critical and you are not able to access it. Now, sometimes you might, use or take help of your colleague to send the data via, some third party emails, email drives or so on, which is not secure. Then there is a difficulty with the employees engagement wherein, multidisciplinary, teams engagement is not possible. Team meetings are very difficult. You cannot have face-to-face conversations and so on. And the last is the IT administration. So I hope that you agree with this, that whenever you are working from home, there might be some issue with your laptop, there might be issue with SolidWorks or even any other software, and you cannot tackle it yourself. So you have to rely on your IT person, his availability. If he is not physically present, then you'll have to troubleshoot yourself and so on. So it is very difficult. And these are the challenges which we face now and which we might face in the later stage of our work time. So for that, we have a solution known as 3D Experience Platform, which is a one-stop solution to all the issues which we discussed in the previous slide. Also, we can highlight this as more solutions than the problem which we discussed. So in 3D Experience Platform, you can have collaboration with the whole team. So it depends on the admin. He can allow your access to only your team or to multiple teams. So it is customizable. So, and also there is a platform wherein you can collaborate your ideas, you can create your post, you can have a social influence of your organization in a private private space that we will discuss later. Then we have minimal IT overhead and secure cloud solution wherein, you know, you can use the online version of your CAD. So no need of installation and all. Everything sits on the cloud. Simply open your browser, just log in and start your work, save it, and it saves to the 3D drive, which we'll speak later on. So there's a secure space by Amazon Web Services, and this can be used to share your data. So the data stays on the cloud irrespective of wherever you are. So if you are in office, you are logging in and working, it is the same space. If you are traveling home and working from there, it is the same space. So you don't have to, you know, rely on some of your colleague or ask someone to share the data, or, you know, if in case you forget. So it stays with you. And the real-time convenient 3D data sharing and viewing. So, you know, if in case you are working from home and you want to work simultaneously with your colleague, you can do that. So you can share the drive. And suppose if you are working on an assembly and you want your colleague to do SolidWorks drawings, both can work simultaneously, provided the files are shared via the 3D drive. So why 3D Experience Platform? So it is a solution for engineering, marketing, procurement, and manufacturing. It is a social collaboration. It is just like you might be knowing some social media platform these days, wherein you work together, wherein you converse with your friends together. But this is a kind of organization level private collaboration platform. Also, we have marketplace wherein you can register yourself as a vendor or a part supplier or engineering service. So marketplace is available, and it is available on public cloud also. So in 3D Experience Platform, we have, as I told you, we have roles. So we have the base role, that is collaborative business innovator. That is the base role in which you get the collaboration apps like 3D Drive, 3D Play, Swim, Community, Dashboards, Metrics Reader, which we'll see in the coming slides. Then we have collaborative industry innovator, wherein, you know, we have the designing tools, wherein we can do parametric modeling with X Design. We can do organic modeling with X Shape. We can have SolidWorks connector, which connects your data of X Design, X Shape, and, you know, we forgot to add X Sheet Metal. So the sheet metal, which is very new to this design family. So all the data from the browser based solution can be connected to SolidWorks, the desktop version of SolidWorks, via SolidWorks connector. And also, if you don't want SolidWorks and you want to design everything on the cloud, and you want to do drafting on the cloud as well, we have the app known as Drafter. So the Drafter role does that. So to access collaborative apps, you only require collaborative business innovator. But working ahead, if you want to do design, if you want to do the PDM, the data management part of the thing, or you want to do simulate your designs, you have to have the collaborative industry innovator role. So you must know that the base role comes with the collaborative services only, but the additional apps has to be purchased only after you have the 3D innovator, the industry innovator role. So as you know, that we discussed about the challenges and the business office intangibles, the value proposition is like, we have to meet the common goal with the common resources. We have to engage with all of our employees. We have to share the data and information in the real time. And also we can conduct meetings with the conversation app. So everything is available in a single interface. So let's dive in. So Collaborative Business Innovator comes with few apps. You can see here, that is 3D Dashboard, 3D Drive, 3D Play app, 3D Play, 3D Swim, and all. So just to simplify it, consider this as your cell phone wherein you have an operating system. So now collaborative business innovator becomes your operating system, and all the apps here gets pre-installed on the browser. So simply you have to open the browser login and you have to access it. No need of installing it on any local system like C drive or D drive. So we will discuss about this six or five apps which we see here. So let's talk about 3D dashboard. So in 3D dashboard, you can personalize your own company standard dashboard. So whenever you log in with the website, you get the same interface and the same layout which you want to. So now this layout can be customized by the admin, or it can be customized as per the user requirement. So the admin can create a dashboard and can share it with the team, or the user can create his own dashboard as per his requirement. So suppose he wants to do, he keeps on posting a lot of, comments, and he wants to see whatever content he has uploaded. He want to view the files. So in that way, he can, drag and drop the apps as per his layout requirement. And that can be customized by him. So in the 3D experience platform, you can see here that you log in to the browser, and in the browser, you can see we have roles and the apps. So simply drag and drop whatever apps are required. So in the compass, you can see we have set of apps available. Simply drag and drop to your browser and the layout stays forever with you. Simply you have to create the dashboard. So next time when you log in, you get the same interface available. So here we are creating an engineering data tab. In the tab, we have added the 3D drive and the 3D play app. Then we keep on adding whatever tabs are required. So in the community, you can have a community of your organization department wise, or probably the whole whole company altogether. So in the community, you can add posts, you can see ideas. So here you can see we have multiple communities. So multiple departments can be added. For your sake, we have added a few communities. And in the communities, you can see the discussion going on. That this is an idea, we want to do this. What is the project going on? And what is the project state? So it is from ideas to concept design to manufacturing stage. So each and every status can be viewed on this tab, in the communities tab. Then we can also have analytics wherein we can integrate our Excel sheets or maybe Google Sheets for real-time feedback, and we can see the analytics. Also, we can have the analytics of the community wherein which community is, very active, what are the contents uploaded, who has created what data. That can be viewed here in the community. So here you can see that the community has the predefined apps available, which we can drag and drop and place as per our layout. You can have multiple tabs, and then in the settings, you can share the community as a leader, as a reader, as a contributor, or as an owner. So if you are the admin, you create a layout and you want that all of your employees or all of your colleagues to follow the same layout, you simply add them as readers or contributors. So the reader can only read the content. The contributor can add the comments, and the owner can change the layout. So then comes the 3D swim. So now in the previous slide, we saw that we created a 3D swim community, the dashboard. So in the dashboard, we added a swim community. So how we use the community? So we can see here. So in the community, we can add photos, videos, or 3D file content. We can create Vdoo. So it is just like to-do list required, or if there is a design manager or a manager who wants someone to do some work, he can use the Vdoo work. Your teammates can create ideas. You can create surveys or questions. So someone can ask question and anyone other in the team can reply on the same. So it is just like another social media, but customized as per your organization. Then we have wiki pages and ideas. So here in the same here we have the community. In the community, you can see that there are multiple people who have added images and multiple ideas. Here you can see that someone has posted that the design has been completed. And in the 3D drive, you can see that there is a space wherein the data is available. There is a 3D play available. And you can search the data. You can see that someone has commented that the CAD is completed. So just to verify that it is completed, he simply opens the 3D drive and drag and drop the file to 3D play, and he can just visualize directly in the browser. So no need of downloading the file, no need of opening SolidWorks or any other software and opening the files. So it is simply that he can just view whether the file is complete, and then he can commit in the same community that okay, so here you can add markups. Or if he says okay, this is fine, he simply adds the comment to the community, and he adds the title that okay, this is good to go, or there is some change required. So here we find that it looks good, and we add this picture to the community. So directly from the 3D play, simply publish the image that this is good to go, and we want to have a dozen full of the prototypes. So simply in the community, we add this post and we refresh it. So here you can see that we have added the comment in the community in itself. So you can create communities as per your project also. So suppose you are working on 5 to 6 projects, you can have communities at the left side of this pane, and simply go to that community and you check what is the progress of the project, and you can share the ideas or you can comment on what is the state of with the ideas. And also here we have timeline wherein so multiple projects are seen here. You can simply drag and drop the project from feedback to under review or under review to under development or maybe implemented. So in this way we can check the state of this thing. Then comes 3D drive. So whenever we create any data on the 3D experience platform, it gets saved to 3D space and 3D drive. So in the 3D drive, you can open SolidWorks file. So here we have the SolidWorks interface, which you will see in later stage, that SolidWorks files can be drag and drop to the 3D drive, or 3D drive contents can be drag and drop to the SolidWorks. So there is a 3D connector interface, which we'll speak later. But the 3D drive is a one-stop storage solution for your CAD data. So with Collaborative Business Innovator, you get 5 GB of the space. The space can be increased as per your requirement. But with CA Collaborative Industry Innovator, you already get 25 GB. So in short, you get 30 GB of data without having to increase it. But if you require more space, you can always increase it with more storage space requirement. So you can open the SolidWorks files, you can preview the files in 3D Play app, it can integrate with Windows Explorer, as I told you, with the SolidWorks connector. And here we have also the version management, so which we will again see it later. So what that means is whenever we edit some assembly, you get a version history wherein who has created or who has modified the files. So that can be done. Again, the files can be shared. So let's dive in. So in the platform, we have 3D drive. Here we have my files. You can add a new folder if required. So whenever you want to create some project, you simply create the folder and you open the folder. And you can upload the files directly by clicking on the select files, or you can drag and drop the whole folder. So here 3D drive is very intelligent, wherein if I had to use any other third party storage space, if I simply click on one file, so this is a SolidWorks file, but if I use some other third party 3D space file, I select on this, it will simply upload the same file only. But 3D drive in this case is very intelligent, wherein it asks you to upload the relevant part files also. Okay, that means that if I have to upload the assembly, it will recognize that it has missing referenced files which has to be uploaded. So it will upload all the things in one go. And then you can drag and drop the content directly to the 3D Play app, and wherein you can view the whole assembly. So no need of using e-drawings, or no need of using your SolidWorks again to open the files. And, you know, again, you can have the perspective mode and no shaded, the display states are available. Also here you can explore it, explore the assembly to view how the explored view looks like. And then also you can measure it. So here we have the measure option also. Now here you can see that the explode is incremental as per the sub assembly. So it will explode at the top level first, and then at the sub assembly level, you can add markups to this. Okay. So here we added the markup, that is check for interface. We validate it, and then we again, we add this component. So now once everything is done, again you go to Swim community and you post the images to the community. Also we can share the files to our colleagues via user. So if you have user on the same platform, you simply type their name. You can send them via link. So probably you could copy the link and paste it to the email, or share with groups. So suppose you want to share the whole assembly with manufacturing department. So if you have created groups in the platform, simply add the group and it gets added. So here you can see the same files are cached on the local drive as well. So what happens is whenever you upload it, the same copy is there on the local system as well. So if in case you don't have access to internet at some later part of stage, you simply go to the local drive and open it. Again, we have collaboration with Dropbox, Google Drive and OneDrive, where if in case you want to upload more files to the platform. So that can be integrated, wherein you can first see the files. Then the 3D Play app, as you already saw, that the 3D Play app gives access to, you can add markups, you can do section views, you can measure the components, you can add annotations, and you can add text. And then once everything is done, it gets added to the community. So this we already saw in 2 to 3 apps presentation, so we don't have to see the video. Then we have 3D search. Now, when you create content or when you upload content, there are a lot of data which is going to be there in 3D drive. Now, if you want to find some component, again, if you had a traditional Windows Explorer, we simply go to search and we find it. But it is limited to only file name. But here we have 3D search with the tags, wherein you simply go to the search bar, you find my contents, and you can filter it, who has done it, when it was done, what was the content type, and so on. So who is the owner, and so on. And also you can specify the approximate date in which the content has been created. So you can simply select who, when, what, where, and why, and how, and then type the name. So it can be a file, it can be a physical product. So it according to the filter, it gives you the result. So here you can see the trend of the component. So it is a file or it is a physical product. So physical product is a kind of solid body which we get in the platform. This is the another name nomenclature which we call in 3D experience platform. So then we filter it by a date. So approximately up from this date I had uploaded the file, because I forgot the name. So we can simply add, select on the owner, or we can select which person has done. And then you can see the filter is, filter results are reduced, and then you can scroll and find your components. So if in case you have forgot something, you forgot the file, the 6W tags in the search help you to create this, find this thing. Also, you can see the properties, who is the owner, what is the file size, and what is the version. Then we have 3D message or conversation app. So now when we started with the webinar, we saw that there is an issue with the team collaboration. Now with 3D messages app, you can have a personal call, voice call, or a personal video call, or you can do chats, on the platform, or also you can have a group video call or a group voice call. So in this case, 3D messaging apps help you to do the team collaboration directly from the browser or from the same platform. So now what we mean is that you don't have to leave your browser. You don't have to leave your working environment. Simply go to the app and do the necessary things. Nowadays, in the situation, we know that we install a lot of apps, which makes your system unstable. You know, we have to rely on, you know, some other third party apps for your email. You have to rely on another third party apps for your messaging. We have to rely on another third party apps for your video calls and so on. And then other third party apps for your storage. And you have to rely on SolidWorks again for design. So, you know, putting the proposition, we can do all the things on the same platform with the same login. So that is 3D messaging. So with Collaborative Business Innovator, we can centralize the information. With a 3D dashboard, you can collaborate across the organization with the community. And we can securely share the data with the 3D drive. So it can be, you know, useful for engineering team, marketing team, or the sales team. Now comes the collaboration of SolidWorks with the 3D experience platform. So here is the typical SolidWorks environment, but here in the task pane, we have the add-in for 3D experience. So simply log in with your credentials and the same browser-based experience is available now inside your SolidWorks. So here you can see the same compass and, you know, the 3D drive app available. You can simply go to your folder, whatever folder you are, you know, working on. Probably we want to create a new folder for this drawing. So this is an Hopper assembly. We'll create a folder directly from SolidWorks. So here we are not using any browser. Okay. We are relying on the plugin, SolidWorks connector plugin. Now, when you click on add files, you can see here that it adds the drawing as well as the whole assembly. So you don't have to pack and go the whole assembly and, you know, upload it to the 3D drive and so on. So here it intelligently sees all the references. And once you click upload, what it will do is it will simply upload all the files to your 3D drive in the same folder which we have. And also the same files gets uploaded to the cache folder. So here you can see in the C drive, we have the cache folder. Again, the cache folder can be configured to the D drive or so on. So here we have the whole tree. And if someone is viewing only from the browser, he can see that the files are available now. So suppose you are the design engineer, you upload the files and you have design manager sitting at some other location. He simply uses his browser and he sees the files and you are continuing to with your work on the platform with SolidWorks. So here you can see we have uploaded this file. So back to SolidWorks and we make some changes to the drawing. So now we have uploaded the files. So that will be with the base revision. Here we keep on creating some work for the sheet. So we are adding a hatch with the section view. So here the section is added and probably we go and add a detail view also to this. So we add a detail view to the sections, the specific area, and we add the detail view. So then we save it. So notice that what happens now. Once you save it, the file is saved with a revision to the platform. So here you can see the properties. See the file history. So the file has been changed. So that is the revision one now. So now we keep on adding more data to this this drawing. So in the drawing view, we add another detail view. We add more section views to this component. So this assembly drawing. So the drawing is now more modified. Now we again save it. Now again, if you go to the platform and check the property, you can see there is another revision here. So in this way, there is a revision control inbuilt in your platform. So the same thing happens if you don't have SolidWorks and you only go to the browser and check for the component. So you can download as per the revision as well from the platform. So this is how we can integrate our 3D experience with the 3D experience with the desktop version of SolidWorks. So here we have 3D experience platform wherein, you know, we can integrate with the desktop, or we simply have the apps on the cloud. So on the cloud apps are available, but you can simply link that with your existing SolidWorks desktop version to this. Now going ahead, we have 3D creator and 3D sculptor. So for the drive, we have this dashboard. In the dashboard, we see some, you know, websites also. We can add a web page reader, and we want to add a part to this component. So here you can see in the 3D play, we have seen that there is a component attached to this assembly, but we simply want to create a part on the browser. So in the play, we simply verify that we want to do some changes in this assembly. Here you can see the stand is there, which is not that aesthetically accurate. Also, this part needs to be modified in this assembly. So how do we do that? Simply go to the 3D creator app. So this is the app. This is a web-based app, you can see. And we simply create sketches as what we do in any other CAD software. But this is done on the browser, on the cloud. So simply add the features. So here you can see the same nomenclature of the features which we have in SolidWorks also. And here we have the feature manager tree. So design manager is available. You simply create sketch, then you extrude it. We keep on creating the features, and it gets added up to the feature tree also. So we add a lot of chamfers, a lot of fillets to the part, and we add the same history to it. Then we mirror the component via plane, and we can mirror the body as well. We can add references of the sketch. So it can be a perpendicular, it can be parallel, it can be horizontal. We can add the dimension for the sketch. So it is very easy, and we can create the same in the browser. So no need of installing anything. Simply add your features with the sketch relations as parametric. You can do a cut, revolve cut for this feature now. And then we can replace the component. So here you can see we replace the component, and again, it is so intelligent, it asks for the mate references just like SolidWorks, and we add the missing references. So it can be a coincident relation. And notice that this is the same feature tree for the X design. So there is no separate part mode, or there is no separate assembly mode. Whenever you drag and drop the component from 3D drive to X design, it asks you two things: whether to merge it or whether to add it as a part in the assembly. So it will be the same interface. You don't have to rely on any templates. It is the same interface wherein you get the assemblies and the parts simultaneously. So here you can see that the assembly has mates, and the mates are visible in the mates folder, just like what we have with the typical SolidWorks. Now here we can see the motion, the range of motion in the browser also. So a foolproof solution for assemblies and part design directly in XDesign. Now notice that once your work is done, you have this PLM solution wherein you can add your comment, and or you can, you know, assign that a comment saying that I have done my work. And you can see from to do, we had dragged it to in progress. Now when the work is done, you simply drag and drop the content to the done. So the deliverable person, so probably it should be a design manager. Design manager will get an intimation as a notification saying that your work is done, and this is the location of the file set. So no need of design manager, you know, calling up to the design engineer saying that is my work done or not. He can simply see the collaborative task page. He can see what are the works assigned, what are the works in progress, what are the works done. So in conclusion, he can see what is the status of the project going on. So this is everything on the platform. You don't have to rely or wait for someone. You simply have to see the progress. Or probably if the work is not done, you simply can add the comments and you can make the person get the work done. So in short, 3D Creator, we have design guidance. So design guidance is just like SolidWorks topology, wherein SolidWorks will specify you which areas of the components needs to be removed or where the material can be removed. So you can simply add the fixtures, you can simply add the loads, and it will give you a design guidance wherein, you know, it will give you some more, you know, organic or optimal design for designing your product. Then all the features are available. You can reuse or rework with the feature manager tree. It is a single modeling environment, so you can simply design and not on the assembly structure. So you can edit the part directly in the same window, and you can do, you can create assembly from the same part in the same window. So you don't have to, you know, see on various templates and so on. Also, there is a built-in version control, and so there is no requirement of data management solution. You simply have to edit it. You simply have the whole version on the cloud, and you can download the contents or you can open as per the version on the cloud. And you can collaborate with your desktop. You can collaborate with your team. You can collaborate with within the net. Now for the stand, we go with organic modeling. So here we can see, we can add a blob and we can have a push-pull configuration for this surface. So what we are seeing is a closed surface as of now. We take reference of pictures. So this is a free form surface. We select the edges and we simply drag it to form the required curve. So notice that this is very difficult. The organic modeling is very difficult with the surface modeling in a typical desktop application. But here you can see that with the image references, we are simply pushing and pulling the component to match the reference images. So here you can see that the shape gets maintained in this component. Also, we have draft analysis. So suppose you are doing this mold, injection molding. So you can see with the push-pull configuration, whether it is going to have a positive draft or negative draft, or, you know, zero draft variant, you want to add a draft. So with the push-pull, you can see with the color. So yellow is not good for injection molding, green is good. So this looks perfectly fine for now with the draft analysis. So again, in this part, you can see the part is created, but maybe sometimes you require a component, a parametric model. So here is a shaft and we want to add a perfectly round hole over here. So for that, we instead of using the X shape, we go to X design. So with the X button shortcut, you can simply jump between the apps. So no need of, you know, here you can see there is an X shape. We want to jump it to some other app. So for that, we simply go to X design now. So with the X button pressed, you simply have the same interface, only the app changes. Simply create the sketch and then do the extrude. We add the fillets to it, so it looks more accurately aesthetic. We add more fillets, and then, you know, if required, we want to add a hole, we simply go to the feature and we, you know, cut with the same sketch. So here you can see we have added a parametric entity to this X shape. And again, we do a shell command. So here you can see we have created this organic model with ease in X shape app, which can be done with your desktop, but which will take a lot of time, because in typical desktop environment, you have to create 3D sketches, you have to create, you know, planes, guide curves and so on. So it takes time, but here it is very easy. You just simply have to upload your images to the plane as a reference and you can do the design. So again, you go to the collaborative task, you add your comment that your work is done, and you drag and drop the progress that the base cover design is complete to completed. And again, the project work notification gets assigned to the target person that shall be design manager. So 3D sculpture can be used to create subdivisional modeling or organic modeling, what we call. You can push-pull surfaces to create complex models. So it is a single design environment. Again, as I told you, the same environment can be X design or X shape, with the press of a X button. It has built-in version control. It is connected with your SolidWorks. So whatever you design in the X design or X shape, you can import that in SolidWorks and you can use it for the assembly's purpose. Then we have sheet metal, so which is very new to the 3D experience platform. So those who are into sheet metal industry, those who want to do sheet metal components, they can use the onboard app, that is XSheet. So here you can see that the whole assembly is created with the help of XDesign and XShape, but we want to add a sheet metal to this. So just like our intent, we create sketches and then we add edge flange, but here we call it as wall. So we can add the side walls. So wall on edge is the nomenclature here. We can have what will be the height of this, what will be the offset of the edges, and so on. So here you can see with the same interface, we can also add slots or cutouts to the sheet. Here you can see we have added a cutout at the side view, now at the front view of this, and through all, we can up to last. We can also add tabs. So this is a custom sketch which we add to the edge of the sheet, and then we use wall on edge to create the tab with the required details. So here we keep on adding the data, and again, if required, we can flatten it directly in the 3D experience platform. So again, we can go to the sheet metal property and you can add a coronal relief type. So you can have a circular square. So here you can see now there is a circular reference relief. Again, we can mirror the bodies. So the whole body can be mirrored in the opposite direction. And once mirrored, again, we get the flattened view of the sheet metal. So with X sheet metal, you can do sheet metal designing for cabinets or some enclosures, or any sheet metal category in this 3D experience platform. So it is specifically for sheet metal functionality. It is, you can create sheet metal components. It is very easy. So for concept designing, you can use it, or maybe for final use also you can use it. You can use the drafting app to open the sheet metal component. Also, you can connect this to SolidWorks desktop. So that is it from our end. Now, I hope that you understood the basics of 3D experience platform and all the apps, some of the design apps available with the platform. So now let's open up for question and answer. So you can use the question and answer window. Please ask questions and we'll be happy to answer all of the questions. So if you can see, there is a question and answer section. It should be at your right side of the screen when you open the webinar. Again, we made sure that there is a recording for this, the whole webinar. So at the end of the session, maybe in the chat window, you can add your email addresses and we will forward you the recording. Or if time permits, we will upload the whole recording on our YouTube channel. So if you have not subscribed to it, you can go to YouTube and search for Adamix Technologies. We make sure that the webinars are uploaded on our YouTube channel. So we have a question from Chaimin that these are add-ons in the regular software. So as discussed, SolidWorks will have a SolidWorks connector plugin, which you get with collaborative industry innovator role, on top of which whatever role you select. So if you want to do only parametric modeling, you can go with 3D Creator. if you want to do organic modeling, you can go with 3D Sculptor, or if you want to do only sheet metal, you go with 3D sheet metal. So this acts as an add-on, but for that you will have to get a CBI, that is Collaborative Business Innovator, CII, that is Collaborative Industry Innovator, and the role. So you have to subscribe to that roles, and then with the connector you can have as an add-on to your SolidWorks. So it is up to you. You want to work with SolidWorks, or you want to work only for the platform. So you can work both ways, and you can work only for the process. So it is up to you, like how will be the use case scenario for you. But yes, it can be called as an add-on to your existing SolidWorks in that way. I'm still waiting for questions.
Richie?
Yes.
I think there are a few people who want to get the recording of the webinar. I think they missed it. They've given us the email ID on the chat. So after we are done with the webinar, what we'll do is we'll just send the recording to all the attendees.
Yes, that should be fine. Like, we have a list of registration. Instead of sending individual emails, I will always suggest that they check into our YouTube channel. So what we'll do is we'll share the YouTube link to them via this email, so that they can go to our YouTube channel and check it.
No problem. So you upload the recording on YouTube, and then we'll just put the mail to the concerned people, whoever asks for the recording, and we'll tell them that it's up on our YouTube channel already.
Yes. So by 4 p.m. today, so that will be the max time okay. Wherein the YouTube will YouTube video will be up and running. So YouTube video will be there.
Perfect. Okay.
Yeah. So there is another question by Mr. Jaimin again. Need to pay for this? Yes, this is a platform service subscription module altogether. You will have to pay, and the amount will be as per the roles you opt. So if you only want collaborative collaboration with no designing and all, there will be a separate cost. But if you want to do design on top of it, there will be a cost. So Nimit from our team is the right person to speak about costing. But if there is any specific technical query that you find it, I am there to help. I can see so many email addresses popping up on the chat window.
Richie, what I'll do is I'll just reply on the chat to everybody saying that we'll upload the recording of the webinar on our YouTube channel. Kindly have a look at it by the evening or tomorrow. Is that fine?
Yeah, that should be fine. Okay, so the channel name is Idonex Technologies Private Limited. I'll just you should see the answer or answered. So with that, what I'll do is I'll stop the recording.